Hey, what is up, heroes, and welcome back to some more Tales of Berseria. Last episode, we got the 6th Faerion, and now we're on our way to get the 7th. On the way, Teresa came out of, like, nowhere on this boat and said, basically, she lost her access powers and she wants us to kind of stop Oscar, but not kill him. Basically, plead him for his life.
Teresa, it's been a while.
We haven't seen each other since the throne. But that doesn't seem like so long ago to me. Not when I keep hearing so much about you. Eleanor Hume, the traitor.
What of the Corsair Scourge?
Nothing to worry about. I've had my dose of Solitoma.
Was it as bad as you remembered it? Brings you back to when you were an initiate, doesn't it?
Why did you betray us, Eleanor? When the Abbey made you a patrolling inspector, they placed great responsibility upon you. Oscar should have been the one to take on that role. He had already been selected for it. But you wanted it so very badly, and that sweet, naive man that he is, he let you take it.
I had no idea. Oscar had already been chosen?
Yes, and after he passed on it, he was stationed on that dangerous island where he sustained that awful wound. And now, you accompany the monster that nearly killed him. I feel I have a right to some answers.
My desire to save humanity has not changed. I have simply found a path different from the Abbey's.
I don't find that answer acceptable.
I didn't think that you would. I know very well that you offer no compromises when it comes to Oscar.
You're right. I don't. Be sure to inform your new friends of that fact. In order for me to protect Oscar, I'm going to need you all to trust me. That's all I have to say to you.
I understand.
So that skip basically just summed it up. She was very sick, we saved her life, and now basically gonna be bargaining and gotta grab that so we can start hoverboarding. What is going on?
I heard that they use this island to hold exiled prisoners. Just looking at this place depresses me. I hate it here.
We can't go carelessly wandering about. This place is dangerous.
I know. Still, from the looks of those ruins, there used to be one impressive civilization here. I can practically taste the hidden treasure.
The punishment for tomb raiding is quite strict, you know.
Think I'd be a pirate if I was afraid of the Abbey?
I won't stop you from looking for loot. But if you get into trouble, don't expect us to save you. Got it?
Aye, aye, sir.
Yeah, we'll probably end up saving him. Oh, I remember this place from the demo. Wow, the demo actually let us go quite far, didn't it? Wow. Oh, we can't hoverboard just yet, but we can jump this, so... it's fine. So the same sort of crystals that was in the forest with the rhino stag beetle. I assume the boss you fought in the demo is probably going to be the code red enemy we'll find around here. Do you want to battle? Yeah. Oh god, oh, ooh. Yeah, that's fine. Ooh! They just... oh no, just flattened themselves. I thought they revived themselves for a second then. Actually quite fun to fight, to be honest. Don't do much damage, easy to take out. Pretty good. Just gonna get as many materials and souls as we can get. Need some more materials because we're lacking in some. Since I dismantled everything and just upgraded everything as I could. And obviously souls, we need a lot more for the next cat's chest. Pick up some of that. Oh, what is this? Gonna need to hit a crystal to get, maybe on the other side to get back, but not going. Oh, I know, that's the only way to go. Ah, I can see the crystal from here. That's fine. Just gotta smash this boulder. Nice little kick. Love it with our feet of steel. Alright, this should unlock the door. Grab the chest. Do you want to make it a dangerous encounter? Because I would be down for that. Come on. There you go.
I don't think we have a chance.
Thanks, Luffy Set. I don't think we have a chance. That's a mistake. Oh, hey! He wasn't kidding, was he? Oh my goodness. Can I just get like a chance? I can even get these. Right. Let's try this. Also, a really bad start. And now I'm just going to destroy these. Hey, this is better. Switch Black Stick to revive Mailu, but we can switch her out. Now, if we didn't grow a level for like killing these, I'd be so surprised. Whew! Went in! If we got them combos going, we just went in. That was nice. That move at the start just got caught and then just died so quick. Oh, gotta be a bit more careful against them trees because they are actually pretty tough. But it was kind of fun. I like tough battles, I really do. I don't know what these do just yet, so I'll leave them as they are. Then we can come back and hit the right combination if we need. Okay. So we just hit yellow. Open that, I assume. We've got a blue one there, that might be for the way back, I don't know. Where is the area with the light so I can summon the hoverboard? Be really nice right about now, it really would.
That power number 2 displayed at the throne. Hard to believe he had that hidden in him. Lord Melchior said that number 1 was full of untapped potential as well. If I have the talent to use it.
Teresa, my lady. You seem angry.
Me? At what?
At me, for running away and joining Velvet.
Oh, that? I was careless. An enemy stole a tool of mine. I'm merely frustrated at my own incompetence.
A tool?
I don't care what happens to me now. Not as long as I can save Oscar.
I'm the one who hurt your precious brother. And you're asking for my help now?
Yes, you hurt him. You scarred his face, and his honor, and his heart.
Still holding a grudge then? Well, at least you won't be able to kill me in my sleep.
With no Malakim, I'm an ordinary woman. How could I threaten the Lord of Calamity? I'm painfully aware of my own weakness.
Good. Try to keep out of the way then.
Lady Teresa, Velvet isn't so different from you. She had a little brother, she...
I know all about the Lord of Calamity. But none of that matters to me, as powerless as I am now. This is the only path for me. It's the only way I can save Oscar.
Lady Teresa.
Aww. Alright, so... Okay, you need to hit that green. There's the green, but what's up here? Right, let's go this way first. We know where the green switch is, so if we need to hit the green, let's come back this way. And I forgot to send my expedition off again. Right, so we need green to go that way. And green to go the other way. And I'm just like I said before, having the hoverboard right here is just so helpful. This place is way too big. Well, it's not like it's big, it's like normal kind of Tales of land. The fact that when you get the hoverboard, you get so used to just going that fast, and it's just like, oh, I go so slow. I go so slow. Ooh, chest. Life bottle, perfect. Alright, so let's go this way then, shall we? Oh, jumping across. Okay, I see a save point there. Oh. I gotta break that first, gotta come from the other side. Damn. That's annoying. Let's look at the map. So that's a shortcut just to get... We need to get up there. Nice little shortcut though. If we could take it in the chest there as well. A lot of these little hidden chests. And about 5,600 gold. Not bad. Not bad at all. 217 souls, so still so many more to go. Still so many more. Right, now this should be unlocked there, yep. Oh no, I feel like we're gonna have to. Wait, what are we doing here? Wait, where are we? Oh, break this. We have to hit the blue, leave the green on. Yeah. Is there anything we can do? Where was the last blue though? That's the question. All the way back. Can never just be simple, can it? Where was the blue though? I forgot. Alright, green was down there. I need to hit that because that will open the orange for us. But then the green goes up. So we need to find the blue to knock down the blue wall so we can go behind everything. If that's unlocked, we can't go that way just yet. Mr. Blue Crystal, where are you hiding? There you are. That's what we're after. Hopefully there isn't a red barrier somewhere blocking the path, because that would suck. That would really suck. Oh no. Is it not blocking the path for me? Is there a barrier blocking that exit? I don't think so. We're good, we're good. And we're free!
Malakim are just tools.
What are you brooding over?
I know. Velvet, Eleanor, or Teresa. You're not sure whose little brother you want to be, eh? In that case, I assure you I'm the kindest of the lot.
The cruelest, most devious. That's not what's on my mind. There's something I need to say to Lady Teresa.
Something you wish to say? Then speak, number two.
That's just it. I'm not number two. I'm Lafayette.
Lafayette?
It's the name Velvet gave me. It's very important to me.
Something can be important to you?
Yes. I have feelings. You see, Malakim are not tools.
Very well. I shall call you Lafayette from now on.
Thank you, Lady Teresa.
You're kinder than you look, my dear Teresa. Thank you, Teresa.
You misunderstand. With so much at stake, I don't want to rock the boat.
Velvet, tell me what you know about Teresa and Oscar. I want a clear picture of what they can do.
All right. Teresa and Oscar are...
I can give you the lowdown on everything, Abby! Lady Teresa and Oscar are the best of the best, even among the Praetors. Some call them the Consuls. There are only around 100 Praetors in the world, so we're talking very elite.
Anyone called a Consul is going to be adept at both fighting and leadership. They are key figures entrusted with responsibility for major cities and institutions.
The fighting part is all we have to worry about. Are they better than you, Eleanor?
Yes. I was a Primus, which is a full rank below them. I could never overcome Teresa's arts or Oscar's swordsmanship in our practice battles.
When they were still trainees, they worked together to wipe out dozens of demons in a single night! After that, Lord Melchior kept a close eye on them.
Appreciated. I'll be on my guard.
Together, they sound like a real threat. Thankfully, we're only after Oscar alone.
But Oscar has mastered a new art developed by Lord Melchior! You can count on it being a nasty one.
You really do know a lot about this stuff.
It's a little suspicious.
You think so? Well, I was at the Abbey, so...
Why don't you call him Lord Oscar?
That's what's bothering you? It's because we're both so popular with the ladies. I consider him a rival.
Oh my god. I like all the characters in this game so much. They just feel like kind of so unique and fresh. I don't know. Just really loving these characters a lot. I think we're almost at the end now. Maybe? No, we have a lot longer to go. Well, that unlocks that, which is just nothing. Because we don't have a hoverboard working just yet, so we can leave that alone. As far as I am aware. There's another one there. We need to hit that, because that's going to unlock that way.
It's a beetle.
Yeah. A Lionel Giant Thunderstag beetle, to be exact.
Why do they always have such awkward names?
I think it's a cool name.
I've never been able to figure out why boys are so drawn to these things. What's the matter? Didn't you want to see it?
Yeah. Thanks.
When he was little, Oscar was always running around the woods collecting bugs. He'd get so into it, it was never long before he'd trip and hurt himself.
Did you grab bugs for him?
Yes, I thought they were gross. But I was much taller than him, and I had the reach. Once, he gave me a whole pile of cicada shells as his way of thanking me. I just screamed.
I'm sure he just wanted you to know how he felt. I can relate to that.
Rather unusual for a Moloch like you to contemplate such things.
Well, I try to. It's just really hard sometimes.
It's hard for people, too. Sometimes it feels insurmountable. And yet we can't give up. Sometimes you just have to say what you believe in your heart. Even if you're not good at saying it.
What I believe.
Fee, hurry up already!
I feel like Teresa's gonna maybe become good.
What were you two talking about?
Nothing.
Don't know, I really love it when like Velvet's just like so pushy, like, Fee, hurry up. Because I believe Velvet is one of my favorite main characters from any Tales of game. So she's definitely kind of like unique.
Hey, Lafayette, found a new stag beetle, did you?
Yeah, Lady Teresa caught it for me.
Ooh, those pincers are sharp. Aizen, take a look at this fine specimen of a stag.
Wait, I believe that might be a two-horned rhinoceros beetle.
Listen, you two. If you're gonna get in another fight over this, I'll just say it's a new type of drone beetle.
You wouldn't.
You've really figured us out, huh?
Eleanor, you didn't make him say that just now, did you?
I did not. I've made a pact with him as a vessel, but he isn't tethered to me.
A Moloch, acting so human.
I used to think that way. Molochim possessing free will just like humans? It was inconceivable. But meeting Lafayette and Aizen taught me the truth. They laugh in joyful times, and cry in sad times. Their stomachs even growl too.
Their stomachs growl?
Now I take it as a matter of course that not only Molochim, but demons and Therians too, have their own thoughts and feelings.
I thought you hated demons.
I certainly still do, but now I feel something besides just hate.
Molochim with free will? Demons and Therians as well?
You must have sensed that in Lafayette, or you wouldn't have caught that beetle for him. When you saw his beaming face, it must have reminded you of when Oscar was a young boy. Am I correct?
This conversation's over.
Yeah, she's gonna be good.
Teresa, be honest. Isn't there something wrong with the Abbey using a dangerous experimental art out in the field?
Oscar's the one who decided to go through with it. Don't presume to know anything about who he is.
Oh, I see a code red. And there's the area to get the little hoverboard working. Right, we'll grab the hoverboard. We'll grab the demon because it's closer. We'll get the demon, hoverboard, leave.
Using that arc could be fatal. I can't allow Oscar to try it.
Lady Teresa, is something the matter?
It's nothing. I'm fine.
But you looked like you were in pain.
Oh. I was just thinking a bit.
You didn't have time to rest after recovering from the Corsair's scourge. You're awfully hard on yourself, you know.
And even harder on others, am I?
That's not what I meant.
It doesn't matter. I'm well aware that I'm stone cold. But they say a Moloch never knows his vessel's heart. I said nothing all those times you snuck off to the library, did I?
You knew about that?
Of course I knew. But I was just letting you roam free like a master might let her little pup. Number one didn't wander about like you did. What makes you different?
I'm sorry.
Well, boys will be boys, I guess. But I was planning on punishing you if that behavior continued.
Punish me how?
You don't want to know. It might wreck your good cheer.
Lady Teresa!
Look at how open she's being. Do you really think she'll work with us?
I don't think she's lying to us. But I don't think she's being entirely truthful either. Look, I know I probably don't have to say this, but...
You don't. I won't let my guard down. If I see anything funny, she's dead. And since she has no Moloch, it'll be quick.
The only thing I'm thinking though is... She was talking to a gnome now, wasn't she? Or is she becoming like... Is she becoming a Pharian? Because I think there's only seven heads, so... She probably got the power, same power as Oscar. Which makes me think maybe she's leading us to Oscar, and then it's going to be a trap and it's going to be a 2 against 1. Well, not 2 against 1, but you know, them two working together against us. Which would be kind of bad. The thing I love right now is that it forces us to come this way. So we've got to hit this green crystal anyway, and then we get the hoverboard! Yeah! Oops. Let's turn that. So we need the red crystal. I don't know where the red crystal is. Oh, we'll come back for it. Unless the red crystal's around here, then that would save so much time. I don't think it is. But there's lots of souls we'll quickly grab. Ah, it's time to leave. Nope, there's still. Oh! Okay, I know what we can do here. There's the red crystal I think we're gonna have to hit. Alright, next what we wanna do is go around this way. There's two ways to go here, actually. The save point. Let's quickly save it. Okay, there's two ways to go. I'm gonna break the wall so we can take the shortcut later. So on the way back, we're gonna wanna probably take that.
Teresa. Let's review our plan before we go in.
All right.
We'll tell Oscar that we'll release you if he gives up his weapons and Malachim. We'll tie him up, collect the Therian, and then head for the docks. Once we're aboard our ship and ready to sail, we'll release you. You'll be free to do whatever you want.
Very well. But I want you to promise me one thing. Promise me you won't hurt Oscar.
That depends on him. I'll defend myself if I have to.
Velvet...
Please, do it for me, too. If you want to save Oscar, you need to make him listen. Put your own life on the line. You're his sister. Do whatever you have to protect him.
I will. Even if it means my death.
Just saying, if we kill you, Teresa, he is not gonna take that lightly. He's gonna fight even harder. Alright, that looks like we need a yellow... Oh no, we need blue and yellow? Blue and a yellow to get past there. Wasn't there a blue and yellow this way? See how much nicer having this? Yeah. And now we should be able to go up, and on the way back we'll hit the red thing, get the code red. Heh, red for code red. If that doesn't work, then we have to take a right here. But I feel like this is the right way to go because the little skip played. Grab the silver chest real quick. Boots! Booties! Nope. 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 Oh, there goes. Yeah, let's go with that. You've mastered that now, nice. So I guess Oscar's just around here.
You all know the plan, right?
I'm using you as a hostage to keep Oscar from doing anything stupid. And don't you try anything funny either.
Didn't we just run through the plan, Teresa, like a few seconds ago? Ah, there he is. Before we go talk to you, gold chest is more important, don't you think? Oh, new weapon. No.
I knew you'd come, Velvet. Sister!
As plain as day. Now put down your sword and let go of my fairy. If you don't, I'll kill her.
You coward!
I'm sorry to do this, Oscar! I'm searching for the truth behind the Abbey's talk of so-called reason.
And your idea of reason is to threaten my dear sister's life?
I'm sorry, Oscar. I've become nothing but a burden.
Teresa, no. It's not like that. All right. I'll put down my arms. Teresa, get back!
Forgive me, Oscar. This is the only way I can protect you.
We've kept our end of the bargain. Take him and get out of here.
I can't do that. It will reflect poorly upon him.
Lady Teresa?
Have you forgotten? You're just a powerless human.
You're right. I am a weak, worthless human. But he has shown me the light, and it shines. My body is receptive to Enominat's power. And with it, I can protect everything I care about!
She turned into a Therian?
No, she fused with it!
I'll kill you all! Anything to protect Oscar!
Okay, was not expecting how to fuse into it, but that's pretty cool.
A trivial sacrifice. I'd do anything for my Oscar.
Oh, I should have jumped out of the way of that. It's fine though. Oh, that power hits. Nice. Damn, I can get out of the way of that. It's fine, it's fine. Life bottle. Got a lot of power hits on it, which is great. That looks so cool, man. That was like real, and Eleanor would have been like murdered. She does you pretty tough. I need to actually heal myself up. Have full health and start a battle, that would have been great. Start that on half health. would get out of the way of that attack. Don't want them two balls, do you? Okay, they're gone. I'm gonna stay away from them for now. No, they just did 1,000 damage! Not moving. Oh, I'm dead again. I missed a guard twice now. That's so unfair. Nope, nope. What? Oh my god, she is so tough! So use the Final Fantasy 14, like once the attack goes, and like it starts, just like a massive attack comes right like that. After it's done its initial timer, like, I can jump into it and I won't take damage. So used to that, but oh god, let's no. Okay, Aizen. Nope, I didn't mean to do that! Press one button! All I'm gonna have to do is get a nice combo going. Luffy set. Revive Magilu. Well, she is definitely the toughest one we've fought so far. I need to heal myself up, otherwise I'm going to die again. Can't have that. Revive Aizen in a second. That's the way of the attack! Oh, what? Attack does like over like 2,000 damage sometimes. You can't like live it. We're just moving as well. Really reminds me of like Karuda from Final Fantasy 14 now. So annoying, but this is it. Oh, you're so dead. All these hits and combos going, let's go! Alright, so over. Done.
I can't lose. Not here.
Look, Lady Teresa.
Stand down, or I'll devour you piece by piece.
It's okay, sister. You've done enough.
No, don't look at me. I'm so hideous.
When I was growing up, the only one my mother and father ever paid any attention to was my older brother, the heir. But you, Teresa, you noticed me when they didn't. You looked after me, supported me, smiled for me. I could never thank you enough, my sister.
Oscar.
Now, keep watching over me, Teresa. As long as you're looking after me, I can vanquish even the Lord of Demons.
Take a good look. This is armatization. Here I come.
Oh my god, the art is what? Sarita does in Tezisterium when they fuse the Moloch. Oh my god. So that's not like, I thought that was a thing that happens. So Artorias and the bad guys created it? That's crazy. That is crazy.
What happened to him?
He merged with his Moloch?
That's one hell of an art.
51,000 HP, okay. So glad I blocked that attack right then. Which means if this works, then likeliness of Artorias Melchior and maybe even Orochiru's brother doing this are pretty high. Oh, that's so crazy. Like, I love that this game is like a big prequel to Tales of Zestiria, because just like, it just tells you so much about Zestiria's backstory, and it's just so great. At first, I thought this game was just like its own game until, like, before it came out, I realized there's a few characters like from Zestiria. Laffy set, you wanna pull yourself up, little buddy? That'll do good. Oh, and Eleanor's dead. Didn't even realize. Got to stand that healing circle. That's me dead. At full health, I was not living that. So fast. Got to stop using my square attacks because they're perfect resistant to that. Grip gel. Damn it, confusion. He needs to stop running around the room, I can't get him. Oh, sorry, Luffy set. Yeah, full health, you're not living there. That's like 3,000 damage. Oh no. Alright, let's go, sorry, Mugaloo. Where'd that attack? And I thought Lady Teresa was difficult. No! She fused with a Therion. Okay, tough. But hey, him fusing with Moloch? Oh my god. This is a weak Moloch as well. It's like one of the random ones. That's probably why Artorias wants Luffy set to merge with him. Oh. If that happens, then we're in trouble. Yes. can you not? We can all bunch together like that. We'll do lots of damage. Ouch. Oh, God. He just runs out of reach, and then when you go attack him, he goes for his attack and you miss and just... He's a really annoying boss. Ouch. Can't switch Eleanor out. Really want to switch Eleanor out for Okoro right now, but... Nope, nope, I'm not getting hit by that. Right, I am just gonna stay away from her for a little bit. Right, I wanna try and Magali. Come after me, come on. Follow me. Well, he's almost dead, which is great. He's got 5,000 HP left. HP left a set. That moves so much. Go, 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 go. He's confused.
My sister.
He's losing control of the Moloch.
Damn it! It's turning into a dragon.
Velvet, quick, devour that thing! Stop! He's still.
For my birthday. They're family heirlooms that were supposed to go to his fiancée, but he didn't know that at the time. I told him he should give them to the woman he cares most about in the world. And you know what he did? He smiled at me and said I was that woman. So sweet, so innocent. And you took him away! You killed my Oscar! How could you? How could you? How could you?
Oscar,
You're strong. You're so strong. Teresa, Oscar.
And we didn't even get the Therian we came for.
Oscar came at him first. I had to. It was for Luffy. For my little brother. Just dead. I killed them. I'm the same as Artorias. I killed her brother before her very eyes.
It's not the same.
It is the same! But I didn't have any choice! It was the only way to avenge you! It was all for you! I did it for you!
There's nowhere left to run.
Nowhere for you or for me.
Nowhere left.
You all right?
I ate too much. That's all.
They were close. They supported each other ever since they were children.
I just did to them what they were going to do to us.
And who will killing them save?
The soul of my murdered brother.
Whatever the case, we messed up the Therian part of the plan. They're probably making a new one as we speak.
There's no time to waste. Let's go back to the port and start our search.
Yeah.
That was a very just sad... sad battle, man.
Show them. Let's go.
I had to do it. All of it.
Velvet.
She's not wrong, I mean, like, he came at her. Can we just, yeah. Save time.
I never expected that Velvet would actually eat Teresa.
What else could she do? We never expected that Teresa would be a Therian either.
Velvet and Lady Teresa weren't so different. They both loved their brothers.
Not everyone loves their brothers. Some just want them dead.
So where does this leave us?
It seems we must search for the new Therian that will fill the void left by Teresa.
It won't be easy to find another who could become a Therian.
Then it won't be easy for the Abbey either. And they still may not be able to awaken Innominat. We still can't assume that we're in the clear, though.
No, we can't.
If it takes time for the Therian to be reborn, this could be our chance to strike.
Whatever happened, the Seven Therians' ties have been severed from Enominat. But we won't know if the Empyrean has been weakened until we find out for ourselves.
I can try and see if I can sense the new Therian. So let's go back to the prison island first. But I think Velvet needs time to rest.
Right. If we're gonna take down Artorias, she has to be there with us.
Yeah.
First mate, there's trouble. We got an emergency message from Port Zexen. A ship carrying dozens of exorcists just set sail for Titania. They have orders to eliminate the Lord of Calamity.
Yeesh. Looks like the hideout's not so hidden after all.
It wasn't me! I didn't tell them anything!
Then you won't have any problem helping us. We're rescuing the Therians.
Of course not. I won't let them take Kamoana again.
Wait. That information came from the Bloodwings?
No. From a peddler I often do business with.
Exorcist operations like this are usually kept a closely guarded secret. And you're telling me a regular civilian knew about it?
You think it's a trap?
Trap or not, we don't have a choice.
Our enemies know the odds. If they've set a trap for us, that means they think they can win.
The Armadas!
Yes. They're likely to throw armatized exorcists at us.
Even your demon arm can't eat Armati. You might just have a real problem on your hands.
If I can't devour them, then we kill them.
Yeah, if we overcome the Armati, we can win.
Like with Oscar. But his Armatus was still incomplete.
From what I could gather, if the Exorcist remains armatized for too long, their Moloch will turn into a dragon. But to prevent these dragons from running wild, Melchior embedded a self-destruction art in both Exorcist and Moloch.
To think they would go that far.
This is all just conjecture, of course, but we should prepare ourselves as best we can. Just make sure not to leave any regrets behind.
I really can't fathom what the Abbey is doing.
Even if they did let us know on purpose, why would they leave us be? I would have expected them to press the attack against us.
Even if their aim is to capture our allies as some kind of leverage against us, their plan is too many holes.
What if we decided to abandon Kamoana and the others? They'd be no closer to capturing Velvet.
Do they actually want the Therians back?
What are you saying?
Why did Melchior place that illusion on a ball to lure Velvet in?
That was so he could capture her, right?
And in case he couldn't capture her, he could kill her and create another Therian.
Okay, so if securing the Therians is so important to them, why would they throw Orthrus to the winds?
That's a puzzler. Melchior was right there, and he didn't try to protect Orthrus at all.
I don't understand it. It's like they're toying with us.
I don't see any point in that either. They must know we won't give up.
Actually, that could be close to the mark. What if they're just trying to rattle us? Everything would fit, including the assault on Titania.
Whatever's going on, I don't think we're going to like it.
So, Eleanor, about that Armatus Oscar used, was that something the Abbey has been working on for a while?
I was never involved in weapons development or anything like that, but I did hear of a secret research division. Word was that they were deciphering ancient scrolls and books coming from every corner of the Empire. Apparently, Teresa knew something of the ancient tongue, and they called her in to help from time to time.
Did she work on Enominat's book?
I was never privy to any of the details, but I think the books were mostly about controlling Malachim.
Well, that Siegfried thing of Zavid's is some kind of power control device, right?
The Abbey It was all so they could create the Armatus.
Will Ifrid be all right?
Complete or not, they've seen that they can use the Armatus in battle. They have no use for him anymore.
Let's get back to Titania, Aizen. I'll help out with the ship.
Right. Let's set sail.
We're going to head back next time. So thank you guys for watching. Have a great day. See you then. Peace.